Me a favor,
like, you're
down.
Not a bitch. Take that shit off.
Come on, not take that shit off. Let's get it. Right,
where do you live?
Your partner here, like, he's gonna do something. He ain't gonna do shit.
Where do you live, man?
I live right here. There ain't nothing about
What's
it.
What's your address?
Do something about it.
Huh?
How about that? Take your shit off and do something about it.
A few moments later.
The guy was just being stupid.
Well, what? We came here for a noise complaint, and then it went south really
quick. Yeah, we were all just around, and, like, I don't know, I just got upset, and then I...
Been drinking and stuff, or...
Huh?
You been drinking a little bit?
No.
I'm sure?
Yeah, 100%. Okay. All right. Test me whatever you want. I haven't had a single drink, I haven't had none.
Okay. All right, very good.
Oh, man. I'm going to tell you right now, it warms my soul like you wouldn't believe. It does. I swear to God, it does. When I see videos like this, okay, when I see what happens here, as far as these young kids, these millennial Gen Zs, man, I'm telling you, dude, especially Gen Z, when you see some of a man the way they just have this cocky attitude about them, man. But then when they deal with police officers, dude, and then they get humbled so quick. This one here, man, watch this video here. I'm telling you, when I saw this, I'm like, oh, I got to do a video. I got to do a video about this. I have to. I'm sitting here, man, with an ear-to-ear grin on my face. I'm still smiling from this video. Wait, look at this crap here, man. I'm telling you, it's not even crap. If you're Gen X like me, you're around my age, and you see something like this, you know exactly what I mean by this, you know? I mean, this is a hard lesson for this kid to learn something, man, but... Just like I said, take a look at this. This is crazy.
On May 4th, 2022, officers responded to an apartment complex regarding a disturbance in the parking lot.
Well, before this gets started, I got to give a shout out to Body Cam Watch, man. I don't know where you guys get, how you get this. I've been looking into this, how to get body worn camera video footage, and I'm still trying to figure this out. If anybody knows how do you go through the process of this, I've been looking it up, man, trying to get it so I can access it myself to put content together, you know, and just put it together on my own channel. If you guys know, leave it in the comments below. But got to give a quick shout out to them for this video.
What's up, man?
What's up?
What's up? What car are you in?
I ain't in any of these
Let's
cars.
Let's go. Then you got to get out. Let's go.
Nah, I don't got to go nowhere.
You live here.
I don't got, yeah, I live here. You don't got,
okay, what
you walking up on me like that for? What's up?
What's your address?
Take that vest off. Come on.
Take that vest off for me.
Come on. Take that vest off. You know. Come on. Take that shit off. Let's get it.
Right,
let's get it, bro. What's up? What's up?
Do me a favor.
Take that shit off.
Take that shit off. You laugh like you're not a bitch.
Do me a favor.
Like you're not a bitch. Take that shit off.
Come on. Not take that shit off. Let's get it.
Where do you live?
Your partner here, like, he's going to do something. He ain't going to do shit.
Where do you live, man?
I live right here. There ain't nothing about it.
What's your address?
Do something about it.
Huh?
How about that? Take your shit off and do something about it.
Like
you
want, kid.
I ain't gonna say nothing on that camera.
What
so I'm saying, take
what
that
do?
Off.
What
take
do?
It off. Let me see.
Okay, take it off.
Let
me
see.
Let me get your ID.
You ain't gonna get shit.
Okay.
Take it off and you'll see. Well, what you laughing for? I'm writing your shit. What? Take it off.
Done. Come right
put
now.
Put your hand on your back. Put your hand on your back. Stop resisting. Put your hand on your back. Put your hand on your back. Stop resisting. Stop resisting. Put your hand on your back. Put your hand on your back.
I'm a minor.
So why'd you get in my face? What, you gonna hit me?
No, sir.
Huh?
Please, sir.
So why'd you get in my face then? I told you stop balling up your fist, right?
I did.
Okay, so why'd you get in my face? All right, stand up.
Not me too, sir.
Hey! What are you doing there? Hey, back up! Hey, back up!
Back up, back
up. You doing there? Back up!
Right now.
The you doing there, bro?
Back up. It's no big deal. It's no big deal.
Roll up on your side, stand up.
What are you doing, bro?
Stand up, man. Get back right now. Back up. Back up.
I got him right now.
Now, I don't know if that's his father. I'm still trying to figure it out because I didn't watch the video too. I watched it all the way in, but this guy, I think it is. I think that might be his dad or something like that. That kid's dad, though. But that dude there, he's Gen X. I almost guarantee he's close around my age. So he's going to step in on this thing and you'll see.
What's wrong with y'all?
Nice.
Back up. Hey, back up.
To basically see how he's trying to handle this kid. Get him to calm down, exactly.
It's all good. I ain't doing nothing. No, it's no big deal. It's no big deal.
It's no big deal. Sit down. Do it.
It's no big deal.
Oh.
It's no big deal.
Oh, he got quiet a little bit.
I ain't do nothing.
I'm a child helping.
Joey.
Stop.
What the f***, man? You let the man go to jail?
I didn't have crutches.
What you crying for?
I didn't do nothing.
What you upset for?
You were about to hit me, dude.
I was not about to.
So why'd you bar your fist and get in my face?
Because, dude, you're running up on me.
Yeah, okay, okay.
Get
in
your face, little bitch.
What's going on with him?
Step out.
Hey, give me my keys, bro.
I'm sorry. I was just hyped up. Dude, man.
Oh, what happened to that attitude? You was trying to bring some smoke. You was coming with all that heat. What's up? You was hard. What happened? You was real hard, you know? You know, like you trying to chest up like you a man. Well, what happened? Wait a minute. That was just a few seconds ago. What happened? Well, how come you changed that attitude real quick?
A lot of subjects here. We got 1:10:15.
Why is he going to jail?
If you get in my face, I'm going to
I'm not in your face, bro. I'm sitting as close as he is, and you don't have a problem with him, huh?
It's 3 feet of space.
Are you a bitch,
go stand over there right now.
You're a bitch, bro. You bitch me, bro. You bitch me.
Okay. Okay, Julie. Okay,
yeah, you better. Riley, that's the brother of this 1015. Just make sure he stays away.
I told you several times. I said, hey, stop balling your fist. Chill out.
I apologize.
All right, I accept your apology, seriously, but we didn't have to take it to this level, man.
I know, I'm sorry. Like, I was just hyped up.
It's like 15 of you guys gonna let you punch me in the face. What do you think I am, a punchback? Well, you looked like you were gonna hit me.
I know, and I apologize.
All right, why'd you have, what's all the balling up your fist?
Sorry, I'm just hyped up. There's a situation going on, sir. Honestly, I apologize.
Yeah, but.
Hold it. First, he was calling them all bees and everything, right? Now it's sir. Real quick, it got to sir real fast, didn't it? Uh-huh. Yeah, because you got dumped on your ass real quick. You thought you was big and bad and hard, you know? You looking up at this dude, and it's like, come on, Junior, you ain't as hard as you thought you were. Now it's sir. Oh, let me hear some more.
But listen, man, anytime you come across police, you ball up your fist and get at somebody's face, I'm not, you know... What do you think? I'm going to punch you back? I'm going to let you punch me in the face?
No, I know, sir. Trust me. So if you were to taste me, I'd understand. Truthfully, like, you got me in my ribs a couple times. You did. It's fair.
Dude, yeah. I don't know what your gig is, but I appreciate you coming down. And,
no, truthfully, like, man, I'm sorry. Like,
okay. It's not personal, man. I'm doing my job. I appreciate you being sorry, but, you know, you screwed
apologize.
Up. Okay.
Yeah, I apologize. I was acting big and tough, but I f***ed up. I got thrown on the banner.
Dude, okay, got your ass handed to you in seconds.
Stand by real quick. Do you have anything else in your pocket? Anywhere,
sir,
anybody?
No, check me anyways. I'm okay. Sorry, and I apologize.
You're good. Well, I respect you as a man for, you know, saying you're sorry, but...
No, man to man, I'm sorry.
Gotta do what we gotta do. Absolutely. Have a seat for me.
Right here?
No, over here.
Yeah, that's all
right. I'm right here.
Oh my God, I'm telling you, this makes me laugh so much, man. I'm telling you, these punk ass kids, dude, they think they are so hard. They think they are so hard. It's amazing when I sit here and watch this stuff, man. How these young kids like that, just how they just, I don't know how they raised, how they come up, but they honestly think they're hard. They really don't. They don't get it. They don't know. They don't understand.
I'm sorry.
Have a seat. Put your feet inside.
Yes, sir.
Joey.
Yeah.
Look, we'll call or do whatever needs to be done.
Okay.
I'm gonna explain to you right here what's going on.
Wait a minute, whoa. You see that? Those are brass knuckles. Huh. That's gonna be a problem for you there, Junior. That's what they took out of your pocket, those brass knuckles. That's gonna be a problem for you. It's illegal.
We don't need this other one, do we?
No.
So keep him over there.
Yeah, just keep him away. He was 2 seconds away from joining in.
Sorry about that.
No, you're good, man. This is your house number or your cell phone?
That's cell phone.
Okay, so here's your stuff back. Like I explained to you, unfortunately right now he's going to be arrested for what he just did. All right, they're going to...
What's the charge, out of curiosity?
I'm going to talk to the other officer and exactly find out what his exact charges are. But regardless, he's going to be taken down. Do you know the juvenile assessment center is?
Off
45th Street, just past the hospital. Yeah. You know where the rail tracks are? He's 35. Yeah. That's where the juvenile assessment center is, correct? What's going to happen is he's going to get taken down there. They're going to process him. And then...
Why juvenile?
How old is he?
20.
He's 20 years old? Someone over there said he was 16.
He's 20, then he's going down to county jail.
Yep.
All right. So regardless, you can call down in a few hours. They'll figure out how you can get him home, right?
Yeah.
So,
all right. It is what it is, right?
Are you good with keeping him calm? He's not.
No, I got him. I got him. Can I say one thing to my son before he leaves? So he doesn't freak
out. I'll let him know.
Just crack the window. I don't have
well,
to.
Well, I'll let the other officer know because our supervisor is going to talk to him. And then before they leave, I'll let him know. Before they leave, I'll know you want to talk to him, all right?
I just want to make sure you're good with the other son, okay?
Yeah. I am, but I'm pivotal.
Tell, if we can find out a charge for him, maybe to cool him down a little bit.
He's good.
I think it's probably resisting arrest or something like that.
They've been together because I wasn't around for a while.
It's probably a misdemeanor resisting arrest charge. He was wanting to know. He's fired up about it.
No, I want to be honest. No, I don't care. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm not doing anything.
Back in the house, Junior.
Just kidding. I'm not happy we're here. I don't know if it's working.
Oh,
I remember this house.
They ever had with each other.
I thought I was around for a few years here, so they're very tight. That's all they have.
Like I said, it's probably a misdemeanor resisting arrest charge. I don't know the whole ins and outs of it.
Yeah.
We just can't have him fighting around with you guys or the grandma.
He's just upset about his brother.
I hear you.
If I could just speak to him for a second before he goes, if you could let me know.
We'll try to figure that out here in
or
a minute.
Or do it now. It takes like 3 seconds.
I'm not the one in charge over there. I don't know what's going on. If he did something for us to have supervisors out here, it's probably something that he needs to sit there and think about what he did for a minute, okay?
So they don't want to pop right in and say anything?
No. They said they saw it, but then they were like, no, we ain't got nothing to say. So, all right, then if you have nothing to say, then get out of here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yeah, that's impractical. Yeah. Multiple uncooperative witnesses.
All right, well, I'm sorry I had to turn out this way. It is what it is. If you were a police officer, you probably understand why I had to do what I had to do.
I was raised around police officers.
So, sir, do you have your license with you?
Yeah, I already gave it.
Oh, you guys have 14? Thank you. Alrighty. You want to talk to him real quick?
Yeah.
I'm going to end up taking him to the hospital, and then he's going to take the ride. Okay?
No, I'm not getting now. I just want, can I stand up and at least say goodbye?
Like, no, you can't get out of the car, man. You gotta stay there.
Are you arresting me?
Listen. Yeah, you're arrested right now.
For what? Like, what did I do?
For assault on a law enforcement officer.
That's not assault. I never touched you.
Okay, well, you were about to. That's why it's assault.
No, I wasn't about to.
Honey.
Okay, well, I'm not going to argue with you, man.
Listen, it can go to court and they can throw it out.
Well, obviously, this guy kicked me in his ribs.
No, he's actually halfway.
No, I know. He is definitely.
Dude, I gave you more than, I gave you so much respect, and you know it, man. I gave you respect so much.
Like, I had like 2 seconds.
When you get older, honey.
How many, yeah, listen, man. How many times did I try to tell you, hey, relax, dude, stop balling up your fists?
Like, maybe once. I'm sure it's on your body cam.
It's all on body cam. That's the great thing about having a body cam. It's all on body cam.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I know I'm okay.
It's okay, man. I'm not here to argue with you. I'm just here to talk to your dad real quick.
I know he's not one of those. I can tell with him. I know he's not. So have I. I know he's not one of those. That's what I'm saying. I'm trying to explain to you. Like,
yeah, man.
But
can you at least readjust my cuffs? One of my hands.
I'm going to do all of that before we leave.
Can I have my brother come and stuff to say goodbye?
No. We can't have everybody come say goodbye.
So it's just one person?
Yeah, just your. It doesn't even have to be your dad. Yeah, I'm just doing your dad the favor.
Tell me mom's number so
being
I can
nice.
Remember.
Letting your dad come tell you say goodbye, dude.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
More than anytime, man. Watch your leg.
Oh, man. Possible service.
Yeah, you know, dad's a decent dude, but kid messed up.
Do you have any like marks or anything?
On his elbows, he's got scuffs on his elbows. Hey, my cousin needs to take a couple pictures of your elbow, right, man? You owe me. Sergeant, right here. You can see it from here. Got it?
On your right elbow?
I think they're all bone.
Big deal.
Do you even know what you were called for? Called for like disturbance or what? I mean, I know a decent amount about.
Something like that. One of your neighbors called.
A neighbor calls for a disturbance.
Yeah, something like that.
But why did y'all go after him? Well, of course he's gonna stand against cops.
That's enough.
What happened?
What
happened
to the outburst
tonight? Well, I was just upset. Like, there's a lot going on.
Yeah.
Obviously, I wasn't gonna touch him. You know, I had so much time to touch him. I would have if I wanted. You know.
Okay.
It's just high. Like, I was just being stupid.
Well, what? We came here for a noise complaint, and then it went south really quick.
Yeah, we're all just around, and like, I don't know, I just got upset, and then I
been drinking and stuff, or?
Huh?
You been drinking a little bit?
No.
Sure?
Yeah, I'm excited.
All right. You can test me whatever you want. I haven't had a single drink. I haven't had nothing.
Okay. All right. Very good. So a bunch of people were saying that, like, you got in the officer's face and stuff and told him to take his vest off.
We were close. Yeah. Like, I was talking shit, I'll admit, but that's just talking shit, you know? Okay. If I had so much time to touch him, if I was going to touch him, I would touch him. Uh-huh. You know? I was just talking shit. I'm stupid.
What were you saying to
him? Uh-huh. That's damn sure.
I don't even remember how it happened. So I was just talking shit. Like, I was just frustrated that...
Okay.
Because, like, every time cops come over here, they're just, like, complete assholes. So I'm just frustrated. Like, I was hanging out with my friends and stuff.
Yeah, as soon as this is done, 98, we're taking off.
Pretty close.
Like, closer than you and I right now. Okay.
And like, just, about 2 feet.
Just hooting and hollering and yelling and screaming?
Yeah, just talking shit. That's it.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, I regret it. Trust me, I regret it.
All right.
Sure, you know.
All right. I'm gonna go to the hospital with him and make sure he's good.
Okay. I'm gonna head over there too. And okay. You got photos of him already? I got photos and I just got a story.
Oh yeah, man. Oh yeah. Like I said, I'm telling you, I love seeing videos like that. You know? I do. I can't help it. I get a kick out of seeing him. You know, boy, you know, he's standing strong, smelling himself, wasn't he? So, like, you know, go ahead, take that vest off. Go ahead. He's acting all bad, all hard and everything while he's looking up at this officer that close. Okay. So, cop took him down in seconds, humbled him in seconds. He was all big and bad until he got put on the ground, rolled over on your back, rolled you over, man, and cuffed you, dude. It matters seconds. He was real bad, though, first. So, yeah, when you found out that, you're not as hard as you think you are. And he thought he wasn't as hard as he thought he was. Yeah. Yeah. You FA'd and FO'd and you found out the hard way, son. So anyway, man, guys, leave me a comment below in this video, man. And let me know what you think, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment on this, like I said, and tell me, let me know something as far as how you can leave it in the comments and just let me know what was it like, you know, if you were younger. My age or so, I'm 55, okay? And I'm definitely Gen X, for sure. I am Gen X all day long, every day. How you were raised, man, and how you raised your kids, because I did not raise my kids to be like that, okay? I didn't at all. And because I wasn't raised to be like that. Yeah, I swear to God, if I was like that, man, and my parents found out, being even 18, 19, or 20 like that, man, they'd be all over me. You kidding? I wasn't raised like that at all. I was hard-headed, without a doubt, but I was never disrespectful like that. And this whole thing, man, I swear, this disrespect for law enforcement, man, I'm telling you, all of this crap came about. It really escalated. I said it before in another video. I'm telling you, I honestly feel and could look back over recent history here, not too long ago. I'm telling you, this escalation for just blatant defiance of authority. A lot of stuff, man, escalated. I'm gonna lie, it's around 2008 when Obama got in, and not too long after that, it's just this. Sudden defiance of authority. You know what I mean? Just like, you know, cops don't get any respect anymore. Don't get me wrong. Like I said, there's bad apples, of course, in law enforcement. I don't support bad apples. But these guys do a damn hard job, man. And it's just a job. But like I said, this blatant defiance, and it's just gotten worse and worse and worse. And then you got politicians back then and even up till now talking about, let's reimagine our police force, and policing is just wrong. And it's like everywhere you go, and you noticed in all the blue lead cities all across the country, they've got the worst problem with crime. I wonder why. Because all of them are on the woke train here, basically ready to throw a police officer under the bus at any given second for just doing his job. And I'm talking good police officers out there doing his job. Nah, just group them all into one. They're all bad. So I don't get this, man. And then, of course, it seems like this defiance that's coming out as younger generations encouraged. And a lot of it's encouraged, too, because they're not being held accountable. And that's a huge problem. A huge problem, because it starts there. When you start holding these kids accountable, I mean, you hold police officers accountable for everything that they do. Like I said, you got this whole woke movement as far as defunding the police or something like that, or reallocating funds for different things in the police department, you know, and trying to send it towards everything else. You got them over here in Minnesota talking crazy crap. You know, let's reimagine a police force, and maybe if we have a disturbance or domestic violence case or something like that, a call that they get called out on, then maybe we'll just send a social worker out there and talk it out. Really? You're going to wind up getting a whole lot of social workers dead. All right? The two most dangerous calls a police officer can take, domestic violence and traffic stops. Every cop will tell you that. Those are the two worst calls they get, the most unpredictable and most dangerous calls they get, domestic violence and traffic stops. Hands down, okay? So dealing with this, like, you know, they have to deal with this day in and day out. And then, like I said, and then you got, you know, this little punk kid, man, a little 20-year-old, think he hard, you know, just instantly want to come up and just start talking crap. The cops just start asking him some questions and say, what's going on here? You know, I'm called out here for a reason, not just called out here just to pull up on you for no damn reason. They got called there for a reason. Something's going on. So he starts asking questions. This kid instantly wants to get hard with him. Like, you know, like he Billy Badass or something. I'm like, yeah, until the cop put him on his ass, cuffed him up in seconds. Yeah, and all of a sudden, sir, I'm sorry. Yeah, you know, yeah, that attitude got lost so damn quick. That's why I started laughing. It's like, it was hard till that happened, right? What happened? What happened to take that vest off? What happened? You a bitch. Why you say that? What's up? What happened? He was calling all kind of stuff, you know? Talking that shiznit. Well, like I said, you F-A'd it. F-O'd. Hard. I love it. I love it. Anyway, guys, like I said, don't forget all the other stuff, man, on there. You know, like I said, like, subscribe, share this thing, man, and send it out to your friends. Just send it out there, man. I'm telling you, I swear to God, it makes me laugh. I'll see you guys on the next one.